your neighborhood to break down the upcoming 2K Compete events. This weekend, make your way to the Rec, because all day Saturday and all day Sunday, you can earn
is seen from the shore of Lake Michigan on a cloudless day. Hi, thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports. It's a Monday afternoon broadcast of the NBA. With Hall of Famer Doris Burke and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan. On the sidelines, we have David Aldridge reporting. Hey, Dave.
Hey, Kevin. The Bucks have their transcendent superstar in Giannis Antetokounmpo, but he said, we've got more. We have a great team. Guys who can knock down shots. If there are five people in front of me who want to hold me back from that goal, there are four guys on the court who will make plays. And that's what makes us dangerous. Kevin, back to you.
Very dangerous indeed. David, thanks. So the opening lineup for the Suns. Booker and Bridges are the wings. Jake Crowder out there with Ayton. And it's Paul in at the one. And for the Bucks, Giannis is the four with Lopez the five. Holiday out there with Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Middleton hit the three. Greg, we've got two terrific highlight-making teams, both athletic in so many ways.
You know, it makes me harken all the way back to college. It's one of my teammates, Stacey Ogden, one of the greatest athletes I ever played alongside. But we're going to see a lot of his impact in tonight's game.
Now here's Booker. The ball over Holiday. Holiday with the ball.
An aggressive defender who pressures ball handlers. Nobody should be surprised to see Holiday sending shots away. And that'll start us off already. You can feel the tension in this arena.
You get the sense there is a level of intensity right out of the gates.
Now, here's Bridges. And the wide-open shot from Crowder buries it from three-point range.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Well, that three-point shot just gives you so much room to operate on the offensive end.
On the wing, Holiday, defended by Paul. And Middleton kicks to Holiday. And the three off target. And Phoenix pushing it up now. Booker outside. Count the basket.
This is why I love his game. You really have to admire his tenacity. I mean, such an easy release for Devin Booker. Doesn't have to elevate that much to get that shot off.
And what that means, Greg, is that smooth stroke translates into the three-point shootout. Booker with the all-time record, 28 points in a round. That leads to a victory in 2018 in that contest. That was special.
Here's Booker. Giannis Antetokounmpo making his last shot. And stolen by DiVincenzo. There's the lob at Antetokounmpo.
Savvy play from Holiday. Quick thinking helps him get the ball to the wide open man.
For Phoenix, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Booker against DiVincenzo. And there's the call on Giannis Antetokounmpo. That's his first foul. Holiday against Paul. Booker outside. Pocket six. A three-pointer, no good.
And if they know what's good for them, that's the way they'll defend against him every time he takes the ball on the three-point lane.
And so it's Crowder with it. He'll bring it up for Phoenix. Trailing by two. And there's Booker on the assist by Bridges. Booker's got five.
Well, the mechanically sound shooting form of Devin Booker on display, that is pretty.
Middleton outside. And he gets it to go.
And with great positional size, Milton knows how to do damage down low.
Booker outside. Crowder against Giannis. Trying to get open is crowded. No good from Booker.
Well, this is the kind of shot we've come to expect him to make. He's got to be upset with that one.
The shot by Holiday, no good.
No one to blame on that one but himself. You get looks like that, and you've got to take advantage.
And Ayton stays with it.
What a fantastic offensive rebounder. Ayton's so good at using his physical advantages.
And Milwaukee calls their first time out of the game.
You know, you think back to DeAndre Ayton's college career. He demonstrated three-point range. And while he's eager to show that in the NBA, the Suns want him to attack the rim.
Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Avi Portis is checked in for Lopez. P.J. Tucker comes in for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Pat Connaughton, he's checked in for Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Bryn Forbes in for Jrue Holiday. And the Suns here with a different look. Sharks checked in for DeAndre. Johnson comes in for Crowder. Torrey Craig, he's checked in for Bridges. And it's Payne in for Chris Paul.
And Monty Williams said, offensively, Ayton's got to be 80% beast, 20% shooter.
The reason they say that, Greg, is they want him to exploit the elite physical tools he brings to the game. If he can draw more fouls, he can get to the free throw line. And he's such a good shooter there, it only makes sense.
Connaughton passes to Middleton. There's 45 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Tucker dishes to Forbes. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
You know, that an area where Tucker continues to improve, making the extra pass.
The Suns trailing. Dane, looking around. Passes it to Craig. Off target from three-point range. Milwaukee's gone, 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. 2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. And here's Middleton. He's got five. Milwaukee needs to get off a shot here. Here's Forbes, rejected by Booker. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Contested game so far. Up 3-1. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. And if you're wondering whether players watch the standings, check out this clip from Chris Paul.
One thing we have to do is stop comparing ourselves to last year.
You know, Greg, he makes a great point. Even when you have mostly the same guys, every season is different.
And if you're a coach, it'll give you gray hairs trying to preach that to your players. Many guys don't believe it until they're in it and then have to dig themselves out of a hole.
And we hope you're enjoying the game. Both teams tonight keeping things pretty even so far in the scoreboard. When you consider how the Bucks are doing, what do you guys think?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
Yeah, I think they wanted to come out of the gate strong, and they have. They've taken the early lead here.
They've got P.J. Tucker. He's out there with Chris Middleton. And it's Portis in at the five. That's the group for Milwaukee right now.
And Dario Saric, the homie, as he was known in Philly, a Croatian finesse forward for this team.
You know what I love about Dario is here's a big man who can space the floor with a shooter. He can balance that with an ability to make plays off the dribble. He's a really sneaky cutter and a very opportunistic rebounder. I mean, this is a big man who will contribute in a lot of different areas. This is what we call highly efficient play, working off the screen, getting to the cup.
Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Oh, Ayton in position.
And we've seen several lead changes tonight. Neither team giving an inch.
And right now you love the chess match, right? The ability of each side to adjust to what the other is doing.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. Greg, you were a physical, defensive-minded player. What are your thoughts on how closely the game is called now as opposed to when you played?
It is, Kevin, and yeah, some people like the physicality of the era I played in, but, you know, I like the beauty of the game with the spacing and the freedom of movement, and I think that's one reason why you see so much switching. It's hard to fight through screens without fouling, and ball handlers have become experts at drawing contact, even if it's, you know, incidental. And I think that's just an area where the game has changed so much that ability to play in space is so vital. It really turned it around here in the second quarter after shooting less than 40% from the field in the first. And Doris, Mikal Bridges, about two national titles in the three seasons at Villanova, got better each and every year.
And think about, in his junior season, he becomes one of only 8 major conference players in college basketball history to average 1 block and 1.5 steals while also shooting over 40% from 3-point range. Boy, that is the perfect resume for a 3-and-D wing.
Now, here is Holiday. He's been patient so far, nothing on the scoreboard yet.
Oh, a nifty finisher. You didn't think Holiday would back down inside, did you?
Phoenix leading by 3. Ball kicks to Booker. The shot that time, not on target. Good D by Lopez. And here they come. Here's Connaughton, defended by Bridges. Connaughton passes to Giannis.
Giannis Antetokounmpo has said he doesn't want people calling him the MVP because he doesn't want to relax. He said he fears failure, so he has got to get better.
It's his first trip to the line.
And you know, you'll take what he can give you from the free throw line. Looking at his numbers, just really not one of his strengths. Shooting in the low 60s last season.
Both shots good from the stripe.
And really, the ceiling for Antetokounmpo is limitless. I mean, he has the potential to be a Hall of Famer one day.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix. Second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played so far. Holiday against Paul. Ayton wide open. And again, it's the Suns missing. The break, there's been some debate. What do you think? Is Giannis the best player right now in the world?
I tell you what, if there's a conversation, he has to be in. You know, some people, Michael, Kawhi, Kevin Durant, he's coming back. LeBron James is there as well, but Giannis is probably the guy to lead that conversation.
Here's Booker. Giannis Antetokounmpo making his last shot. Now, here's Bridges. Back to Booker. DiVincenzo with the rebound. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played, here's Lopez, goes to the reverse layup and flaps it in. Lopez has got the lead up to 3 now for the Bucks.
They're simply going to have to do more than that on the defensive end. Lopez too big for the defense there.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Ball can't get it to go. Milwaukee leading by 3. Dishes to Giannis. There's the pass to Holiday. And again, it's Milwaukee converting.
And you have to be right up on Holiday. When you're not, he's ready to take those quick shots.
Timeout called, the Suns.
Good timing. They're really struggling offensively.
Sometimes it just feels like misses become contagious. He wants to settle his guys down right now.
With some changes. Portis is checked in for Lopez. Chris Middleton comes in for Pat Connaughton. And it's Bryn Forbes in for Dante DiVincenzo. Phoenix also making some changes. Sharks checked in for DeAndre Ayton. Johnson comes in for Jay Crowder. And Cameron Payne subbed in for Booker. Now here's Payne. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Ball passes to Sharks. And slam dunk by Sharks.
And dropping the sledgehammer there, he curbs a 10-0 run by Milwaukee.
Pass to Forbes. 31 seconds left to play in the first half. Giannis kicks to Forbes. Shot clock at 5. The kick out to Holiday. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Portis.
That's miscommunication, and we rarely see that happen.
17 seconds left now here in the second. Al Paul. Up empty from 19 feet out.
Well, he's a quality mid-range shooter, but he can't get that one to go.
And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Bucks ahead, leading by 3. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Chris Middleton. Chris, a big effort from you guys in the first half. How do you keep that momentum going? We know that's coach's emphasis, Chris. Thanks a lot. Back to you.
Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit. The 2K Sports Halftime Show. Hey, everybody. Good to see you back here on our halftime show. A competitive matchup for Milwaukee in the first quarter. They ended the period holding on to a slim one-point lead. They were a determined team in the second quarter, and you saw it come across on the scoreboard. Kenny, your thoughts on the Bucks' first half?
Well, I have to point to their efficiency on the offensive end as a key for them. The way they've been moving the ball and finding the open man, that's been super impressive. They don't need to change a thing, Ernie. At this point, just keep...
And that'll about do it as we get ready... Find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. You look at Antetokounmpo, and this game has been everywhere.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled, talented, and thus far unstoppable.
Getting underway in the second half. Here's the 5 for Monty Williams. Booker and Bridges are the wings. Ayton is out there with Jay Crowder. And it's Paul in at the point guard position. Shots good by Middleton.
And this is what Middleton does. It trades. He's one of the best in the league at helping his team space the floor.
And GA Chris Middleton over his career much improved on the defensive end.
A true two-way player. And I tell you, that 6'11 wingspan helps. Able to use that length to bother shots and disrupt passes.
Pass to Holiday. And here is Lopez, who's covered by Ayton. To the paint, here's Middleton. Bridges with the board. Suns trail by 6. Booker in the corner. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got 3 assists now in this one. Paul against Holiday. DiVincenzo. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. The superstar players always get the headlines, but you need more great role players, it seems, as you look at the history of champions to win. So that being said, Greg, what kind of role players do you look for?
You know, Kevin, it starts on your best player, and I think you go from there. Obviously, in today's game, spot-up shooting is critically important, and then you got to factor in versatility. You need guys that can guard multiple positions, that give you some rim protection, but obviously that can also shoot the basketball. And I think it's critical having that instant offense guy coming off the bench as well. To when your team's in a bit of a funk, somebody you can trust to kind of light a fire.
Good points. Holiday against Milwaukee. No good that time either. Suns trail by three. Bridges passes to Ayton. It's Crowder on the wing. Shoots over DiVincenzo. And he overshot that one, missing. And here's Giannis. He'll bring it up for the Bucks. Shoots it. DiVincenzo can't hit it.
That's one for their first four to start the second half.
Bridges finds Booker. That doesn't go on the chance to tie. Milwaukee leading by three. Middleton with it. Now guarded by Ayton. Out of bounds. Phoenix will take possession. Rim forms. He's checked in for Milwaukee. Phoenix also making some changes. Sharch has checked in for DeAndre. Johnson comes in for Mikal Bridges. And Cameron Payne subbed in for Paul. How about that mobile one block we just saw? Amazing defensive work.
And guys, that's about as good a defensive play as you'll see. Instant reaction to get a hand to the shot.
Suns trail by three. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half.
And if Giannis is anywhere close to you, don't shoot. If his length covers a ton of ground, and boy, is he fast.
P.J. Tucker, he's checked in for Lopez. From deep, Johnson. DiVincenzo with the rebound.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game. You can see he just rushed that a little bit. Lost the focus, I think.
Here's Booker. Sharks trying to break free. Good on that shot. With that, the Bucks' lead is cut down to just one on the basket from Devin Booker. Bucks have gone only 1-5 from the field since halftime. Very slow start offensively. Antetokounmpo looking it over.
And I tell you, Antetokounmpo's evolved into one of the better passing forwards in our league. And when the defense is focused on you that much, you need to be able to find the open man.
Payne finds Booker. And it's all evened up. Booker's got a pair of threes now here in the third for the Suns.
That gives him his second three of the half with three total for the game.
The Bucks have hit all four of their chances so far in this one. That's good from Tucker.
Well, make no mistake, guys. One of the more effective second-round picks we have in the NBA. Tucker provides a steady diet of production.
And the Bucks making a change here. Portis has checked in. The Suns making a change here as well. Ayton, he's checked in for Sharks. Down to five on the shot clock. Portis kicks to DiVincenzo. Rejected by Crowder.
Well, Crowder known for his defense, and you love to see him get high for these rejections.
Phoenix has gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. There's 48 seconds left in the third quarter. Offensive rebound. And that one's good, Ayton. Ayton's got 6 points.
Well, you want to see DeAndre Ayton seek out the contact on the interior. Boy, he's a big-time talent.
Here's Middleton. Rebound by Johnson. For Phoenix, they've gone just a bit under 50% from the field since halftime. 5 out of 11. Booker finds Payne. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. No good from Booker. The Bucks have gone just 25% from the field here in the second half. Through 2 of 8. Tucker dishes to Middleton. Can't get it to fall. 3-on-3. Here's Ayton. Well-timed pass, and it goes straight to the bucket for the layup. And now it's a 3-point Phoenix lead.
Well, you love Crowder's willingness to distribute the basketball. His vision allows him to set his teammates beautifully.
And so it's Devin Booker making highlights for the Phoenix Suns. He's been a major threat from 3-point range. Got 2 of them to fall in that quarter. We've got more in store for you right after this. And a quick look now at the State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
We call that putting it right in the pocket, and he knew what to do with it once it was there.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. Suns leading by three. A moment now to reset the lights. Brought to us by Gatorade. All fueled up here for the fourth quarter. On the court for the Bucks, Chris Middleton is out there with P.J. Tucker. Then there's Dante DiVincenzo. Then it's Holiday. And it's Portis in at the five down low. Here's Middleton. It's hauled in by the Suns. Ayton's got four rebounds now tonight. Bridges, no one around him. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got four assists in the game. Passes it to DiVincenzo. Bucks passing it around. Portis finds Holiday. And right away, the Nets with a three-pointer of their own.
They've been terrific from beyond here in the second.
The pass to Bridges. Fourth quarter still young, just over a minute play. Ball outside. He dishes it to Ayton. And Ayton throws it down.
There's a certain resiliency to this team, and you're starting to see it.
No doubt, keeping it very close. They're going to have to step up even more to get over the hump here.
Holiday, and he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
Great speed and tricks on the drive. Holiday excels at putting defenses in those compromising positions.
Brook Lopez is checked in for Milwaukee. Adesanya DeKubo comes in for P.J. Tucker. Suns leading by three. And the Suns call time.
And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
It's tough to hide your communication. Teams go to great lengths to try to do it, but sometimes to no avail.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Alder.
Hey guys, I had a chance to listen to what Monty Williams discussed with his players. He said, keep grinding. We're in good shape. Things aren't always going to go perfect. Don't let that slow you down. Let's just stick to what got us here. Kevin, we'll see if they can build on this lead.
Final quarter here, and we're just over a minute and a half through it. Ball against Howard, the outside leaner.
Boy, this guy just can't buy a bucket, and yet they have the advantage.
And it's slammed in by Holiday.
And Holiday's nimbleness gets him to the hoop on that one. His athletic ability is off the charts.
And the foul on Drew Holiday. That's his first foul. Game moves along. 2 minutes gone here in the fourth. Stolen by Holiday.
He's really taking care of the ball. That's just his first turnover of the night.
That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. Here's Paul. Count it, and the foul. That's on Brook Lopez.
Well, you can see the tenacity of Chris Paul in play there. He refuses to give up on the shot. Wants to get the end one. Nicely done.
That one falls for Paul. Bucks trail by four. Holiday, the pass to Giannis. Just a little under 2.5 minutes of pass now here in the fourth. Middleton can't get it to go. Phoenix has gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight. 5 of 12. Here's Booker. Lopez with the block.
Lopez needs to hold down the court on defense. An incredible wingspan to get that one.
Shoots from 12. Here's Young. And that took by Young.
That is a product of pure effort, guys.
I agree, and that's nothing new coming from him, GA. He loves going to work on the rebounding, going to work on the board.
What about the decisive finish? Great timing, tremendous force.
And the Suns call time. They're in front by two. 1:58 left in the fourth quarter of this one. And now, let's present our New Balance player of the game, Chris Paul.
And I love that it's been a hard-charging performance. Jump shots have been kind of an afterthought. His main goal has been to attack the rim and put the D in some tough spots and also finish it strong.
Vincenzo. misses the tray. So it's the Suns taking the W in a close one. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Ulrich, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in. We'll see you later.